Hello everyone, today we're going to explore a special type of animation in WAN 2.2. For now, let's call it a transformation animation. Of course, this is just my personal term for it. If there is already a professional term for this, it is purely a coincidence. Now let's take a look at the animations on screen. They almost all share a common characteristic. Either the scene itself is transforming, for example, from spring to autumn, or a bedroom scene changing into a fashion runway, or the properties of the main subject are changing, for instance, the world in a box effect that I've discussed before, and you might be familiar with, or the effect you are seeing now where a desert turns into an oasis. There is another effect we have to mention, which is the commonly seen effect of buildings growing organically. It is important to note that the WAN 2.2 model itself isn't inherently skilled at creating these kinds of animations. But today, I'll teach you a method to push the capabilities of the WAN 2.2 model to its absolute limits. For demonstration purposes, I'll build the workflow on Running Hub. You can access this platform through Running Hub. iRunning Hub is an online ComfyUI workspace that I use frequently because it is always the first to update with new technologies and extensions. You can register for Running Hub using the invitation link in my video description, which will get you 1,000 free credits. Plus, you get 100 bonus credits every day you log in, so you can experiment with your own workflows. Okay, first, let's do a quick breakdown of this workflow. This workflow is essentially a standard text-to-video workflow for WAN 2.2. It starts with the three core model components, the high-noise model, the low-noise model, the text encoder. And our VAE, we are also using the LightX2V acceleration LoRa. Following my previous optimization setup, I am using CFG 0 star here and Sage Attention below it. Further down, we have our prompt section and the sampling section. In the sampling section, to complement the CFG 0 star I am using above, I've chosen the Animate Video Nag node here. My resolution is set to 832 by 480, and the frame length is 81 frames. The sampling process is basically the same as the official one, except I am using the LCM sampling algorithm. After decoding, we get a fantastic transformation effect. Take a look. On a map, there is a white marble base and then a very traditional ancient Chinese building. The Temple of Heaven goes through an organic growth process. For the domain of transformation animations, this level of quality from WAN 2.2 is quite impressive. Many of you have probably already guessed it if you want to create these stunning transformation effects. The most critical part is how you write the prompt. Please note, this prompt uses a very typical JSON format. The main problem we're going to solve in this tutorial is how to write a JSON-formatted prompt to achieve this effect. In a previous video, I taught you how to write JSON prompts for WAN 2.2 and even provided a prompt generator. I showed with many examples how this prompt format can instantly elevate your videos. To make things easy for you again today, I am providing another prompt generator. With this generator, you can use any large language model to help you create prompts. The prompt engineering I am providing comes in two versions, Chinese and English. All right, let's quickly demonstrate how to use this prompt generator. First, you need to choose a large language model that you are familiar with or one that is suitable for the task. I've chosen Gemini 1.5 Pro because it currently has the strongest reasoning capabilities. The platform I am using is still AI Studio. We'll start a new chat here. We can open the system instructions section and paste in this system prompt. The part you need to pay attention to is called core subject information. Here we need to define two things. One is the subject or brand, and the other is the core scene. The term brand is there because we originally developed this for product showcases. You can just think of it as the main subject. Let me be very clear about what the subject is. The subject is the main entity or primary character in the scene at the very beginning of the video. For example, if we want to generate an animation of the Temple of Heaven growing out of a map, the subject would be a map on a table. The core scene can be thought of as the final image you want to achieve. In our case, we want the ancient Chinese architecture, the Temple of Heaven. You can write this in Chinese or English. Then we generate the prompt. The generator will provide both Chinese and English versions. We can copy either one and paste it into our workflow to generate the animation. Let's see what happens. Note that it won't necessarily be a growth animation because our focus is on the transformation process itself. Let's run it and see the result. Okay, as you can see from the result, the model didn't capture the building perfectly, but you can see there is a clear transformation effect. So it is a bit like opening a mystery box. We define the start and end scenes, but we can't really control the exact form of the transition. It is entirely up to the model's own interpretation. Of course, you can add constraints in the core scene description. For example, we can explicitly add the term growth animation. Let's generate the prompt again. We'll copy it. Either Chinese or English is fine. generally use Chinese for Eastern themes and English for Western themes. Now let's run it again. As you can see, this scene is much better. This brings us back to the point I made earlier. There are a lot of uncertainties in the process. However, to make it easier for you, I want to share some techniques. What I just showed you with growth animation is one of those techniques. If you want the animation to be relatively stable, you can design it based on the following concepts. The first design concept is the subject remains unchanged while the environment changes. You'll need to think creatively about this. For example, the desert to oasis effect I showed earlier actually falls into this category, though it might not be immediately obvious. Let's look at a more direct example. Notice the starting scene is a fitting room where a model is changing clothes, and the ending scene a fashion runway. This creates a very coherent transformation as the model walks directly from the fitting room onto the runway. The transition is quite smooth. Let's look at a second example. The starting frame shows a woman sitting in a courtyard, seemingly meditating. The ending scene is a reef in the middle of the ocean. As you can see, this creates a beautiful transition effect. This kind of effect is used very often in commercials or high-quality promotional videos. Other examples include a bedroom scene transforming into a primeval forest, with vines even growing on the bed, a fantastic effect. There is also the classic transition from spring to autumn, or a person lying in bed suddenly surrounded by an endless sea of flowers. That is enough examples for now. You'll notice that in all these transformations, the core design principle is to keep the main subject constant while changing the environment. This ensures a much more stable animation. The second design concept emphasizes changes in the subject's own attributes rather than the environment. These effects are often even more spectacular. For example, the ancient building growth animation we just saw. Typically, we set the starting scene as a map on a desk and the ending scene as the building, like the Temple of Heaven. This gives us a stunning animated effect. You can think outside the box to get many similar results, for instance. I find this one very creative. A ballet dancer leaps from a stage and lands in the sky above a city. This is a great example of specifying a start and end scene and letting the AI video model create a surprising and delightful transition process. Here is another one. The starting scene is a steaming cup of coffee on a table, which slowly transforms into a vibrant city street scene. I encourage you to keep experimenting. You can get some amazing results. Now, let me briefly explain where the inspiration for this came from. It all started with an effect called World in a Box. I've talked about this before and shown some examples. The idea is you have an object, like a box, in an empty room. When it opens, things start flying out and fill the entire space, transforming it into, say, a child's bedroom or some other environment. I really love this effect, so I collected all the prompts I could find for it and had a large language model build me a prompt generator. That generator was mainly intended for Google's VO model. I did a lot of tests with it and found the results were fantastic. Then I wondered if it could be used with WAN 2.2. I gave it a try and discovered the results were quite good as well. And that is why today I am presenting you with this unique prompt generator. Of course, as I mentioned, the model has its limitations. We only specify the start and end scenes, and the process in between is left to the model's creative freedom. This gives it that mystery box feeling. But that feeling is actually a good thing, because most of the time it brings us pleasant surprises rather than scares. Alright, that is all for today. What are you waiting for? Go ahead and try it out for yourself. Follow me to become an AI expert.